Hey, hey, this is director, producer Alan Wills, and I am on Positive Power 21 with Jerry Royce Live. And when I'm online, I listen to Jerry Royce Live at www.spreaker.com/positivepower21.org. Y'all heard?
You are listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide Podcast.
Hello, I'm Catherine Waddell, and you're listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide.
You are listening to PositivePower21.org with Jerry Royce.
What up? It's your boy Kano Kingston.
Hi, this is Angel Sessions.
Hey, this is Pat.
Hi, I'm Teresa Powell.
Hi, Jerry. This is Iowa Sandra Carter.
Hi, this is Phil Powers.
Hello, this is Teresa Barbie with Jerry Royce Live.
Hi, I'm Philip Barron. I'm live on the Jerry Royce Show.
Hey, what it do? It's your boy, who's the same?
Peace, this is Dolly, the poet, spoken word artist.
Hello, this is Lamar Marquis with Jerry Royce Live.
All right, everyone. We got Robin Lynn, and I'm keeping it live right now on Jerry Royce Live.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? What's up? This is a award-winning podcast with the greatest podcast on earth. Thank you for stopping by. I'm your host, Jerry Royce Live Worldwide on Internet Radio, where you get your positive on. So when it's all positive, it's all power. That's positive power. This is a worldwide podcast for growth, wealth, and success. Thank you.
Hi, this is Angel Sessions, and when I'm in town, I listen to Jerry Royce Live, PositivePower21.org, where they play my favorite music.
Yeah, you tell them, Angel, because when you're in Baltimore, Maryland, in the D.C. area, you listen to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide. Thank you, everybody, for joining us, and welcome to PositivePower21.org. Can you feel the power? Can you feel the power of 21, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit? I am Jerry Royce Live. I am blessed. I am worldwide. Philippians 4:6 reads, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God your needs, and don't forget to thank him for his answer. Tonight, you're listening to episode 392. That's right. Tonight, we got Catherine Waddell on the show, and her website is www.thisneedstobesaid.com. Her background is education. She has a bachelor's and a master's degree in education. She's from Charlotte, South Carolina. And we're not going to take up no more time reading no bio. We're just going to bring on and talk to her. Catherine Waddell, welcome to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide. How you doing tonight?
I am wonderful. Thank you so much for having me. And I just love it. I would love this on here. So, hey, Angel, and all everybody else.
That's right. Amen. Amen. That's right. We got a nice cast of individuals who've been part of us for our journey as a Christian network. That's right, a global Christian network. God has been so good to us, and there's just so many people to shout out. I'm just going to say go visit all 24 channels if you want to check them out, and check them out at PositivePower21.org. They would love to hear from you on Facebook. They're beautiful, beautiful people, including our networks with several other entities and networks that's out there. Just everything that's been going so well. Of course, you're always going to have little bumps in the road, but you know what it's like when you're out there podcasting and radio casting and trying to build relationships with people, right?
Comes territory.
All right, well, Catherine, the first question is, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Who is Catherine Waddell?
You know, this is always a tough question. I don't care when I'm asked this question. Oh, my. So let's see, Jerry, if I can find the most interesting answer to give this time I have to answer this question. Who am I? I'm an educator at heart. I'm a mom. I think the most exciting thing about my life is that I've been able to create the things that I wanted in my life. Just knowing that my imagination leads the way. So I'm a creative person. I enjoy writing. I enjoy hearing people's stories. I love everybody has stories to tell, you know, funny things. I'm a child at heart. I love to just be carefree, but I'm serious. And I don't know. Like, I don't ever know what's the right answer for who's Catherine Waddell. She's someone that you want to know. She's great at connecting you with the resources. She's a very resourceful person. But what does she do for her day job? She's a radio host like yourself, and she does that, and that's her way to teach. I felt like the classroom, traditionally speaking, for walls and going in here, and I'm standing at the front of the class and the students are there, that wasn't going to really work for me. So the radio has served as a classroom, and I'm able to bring in guest speakers and facilitate teaching and pulling out the best in people. And I love seeing people become their best selves. So an educator and a mommy.
That's right. Still an educator. Always an educator. Always. Mm-hmm. Now you have a 15-year-old son that's celebrating a milestone in this day and age, right? Tell us about that.
Well, he stands about 5'9". I think we fertilized him. Every time I see him go to school and come back home, it seems like he's grown a full inch. But he's celebrating his birthday today. His name is Maximilian. He goes by Max, and he is the youngest of three. I have a 25-year-old who's about to be a dad, so I'm going to be a glam ma, and I have a middle son that's 24 years old. So all boys, all young men, and today he's gotten, you know, phone calls and Facebook posts, and, you know, got buddies over to play games with him and eat pizza on this evening. So he's celebrating. Max is celebrating. He's having a good time today.
Good for him. Boys keep birthdays simple. You show up with some pizza and some soft drinks and video games. You're a superstar.
You are a superstar. And
I know his friends want to come over because he has a pretty mom, so I'm sure he had no problem getting people to come over.
Right? You better not tell him that they might not be able to come over no more.
He's going to be wondering why they always say, "Can we come over?" He's like, why you guys don't ever invite me to your house? Yeah, what's up with that? Well, they got a cute sister or something. They don't want them over there. Yeah, that's the age right there, bro. You got to have that talk.
You just put me on.
Oh, yeah. I remember that age, man. Seventh, eighth grade. You know,
trouble.
We were looking. That's right. And he's 15. So that makes he's in the 10th grade.
He is.
Yeah, okay. He's same age as my daughter then. Okay. Oh, I got to talk to her. So what's up? And she's tall too. She stands about 5'9", 5'10". She's pretty tall.
Oh yeah, boy. Yep. He's doing good because my oldest sons they didn't get to be so tall.
Oh wow. Baby brother, got him by a couple inches, huh?
All right. He's a big little brother.
That's right. Yeah, I know he likes that. Now, you're running a media company. Want people to know that they can catch you at thisneedstobesaid.com, TNTBS Media Incorporated. Now, you're not in the classroom anymore. You specifically on radio, and that's all you do. So is that
actually? Let me tell you how I never actually got a chance to get into the classroom. Oh. I was getting my bachelor's degree while being an assistant teacher, and I realized that wasn't the place for me. So I never, when I finished my bachelor's degree, I never went in the classroom. I knew that wasn't for me. And that might have been a bad idea for the education system here in Charlotte, North Carolina, but it worked for me. So for the past 6 years, that's what I've been doing, teaching through radio. And that was by accident. Someone suggested I do online radio. And I said, okay, I'll try it. And I've been in love with it ever since. I've always used my voice through my pen or my pencil, writing and journaling. Never had I used my voice. Because you can hear how heavy my voice is. I've always been, who's that guy in the background talking? So I've never been in love with my voice. Mm. So learning how to use it to convey messages over the radio was uncomfortable at first. So I've gotten used to it. I've gotten used to hearing my voice. And so 6 years later, here we are, helping people to find their truth. And I love that. I love that because it's not me telling people, you know, this is what you should be doing. We just open them up to a conversation and leave them saying, you know, I never thought about it that way. And if I can do that, I know I've done my job.
Amen. This Needs to Be Said is a talk show based out of Charlotte, South Carolina. The purpose of this show is to get a message out to everyone who will listen. And you say there's an elephant in the room. Let's talk about it. Now, you have an elephant as your logo. So tell us a little bit about your logo and what that means to you.
My mom always told me, and maybe my mom didn't tell the truth, but I've believed her all the way up to now, so don't you change anything for me, okay? But my mom always told me that the elephant with the trunk up meant strength. And I get a lot of questions. They say, are you a Delta? No, but if I would have pledged, I would have pledged Delta. But I didn't, but I still love the elephant because it means strength. So if I'm in the store and I see an elephant and the trunk is turned down, I'm not drawn to that one. But the ones with the trunk up mean strength. So I have, you know, an elephant around or, you know, especially the logo, and it means strength. Because helping people find their strength like my mom did for me, maybe she made that up, you know, like the tooth fairy thing and Santa Claus. But it worked for me. It has worked for me, and that is, I identify, okay, I have my strength. You know, that's my reminder. So that's the story behind the elephant.
All right. Now, on your page, you have a section called About Us, which I guess is more about you, your story. Tell us a little bit about this story.
Well,
I'm reading, I'm like, whoa, that's pretty much a lot of people. Tell us about it.
Yeah, so when I tell this story now, it's like I was really brave. And 6 years ago, a little over 6 years ago, I was thinking about, you know, doing something that made a difference in the world. And the job at the school system wasn't doing it for me. I was an in-school suspension person. Like I told you, I was an assistant teacher, but my job was to run the in-school suspension room. Mm-hmm. And as I was sitting there for 2 years, I was like, this should be a program because these kids don't get days counted against them, and the teachers have to bring them their work. So I sat there for 2 years, and I put together this program so that there wouldn't be kids that repeatedly came in this room. And I could have had my own home room because I had the same kids for 2 years. That's bad. And that should not be the case. I shouldn't have a role in school suspension. Well, I presented my plan to the principal, and really what they told me is just keep them from writing on the wall and going to sleep. They didn't want to hear about my plan. And at that moment, among other things, because I needed to finish my bachelor's, but among other things, I know I needed to make a difference. I needed to be somewhere where the work I was doing was making a difference, that I was improving something by working there. So it wasn't about the pay. I wanted the pay, of course, and they were on time, and there was some sweet benefits with the school system. So, you don't necessarily just get up one day and say, I'm just not going to do this. And it wasn't like they were late with my check. And, you know, just life was comfortable, okay? I was empty, you know, so it's like everything is good financially, but I'm empty.
And then I also was at the very end of my bachelor's degree, and so as you all know from how old my children are, I was a non-traditional student. So that means I was going to night classes, and it was getting to the end of my education degree where you have to student teach. And I don't know if they've changed this in the past 6 years, but as long as I've known that you have to go student teach for 16 weeks.
Like that.
Yeah. Right, and so what adult can take time off and not get paid and go do student teaching? So either I was going to get to this point after waiting for 15 years to finish my degree and not finish again because my job said I couldn't, so I'm not making a difference at my job. They're not going to let me off for the time that I need so that I can do the student teaching so that I can also finish my classes so I can get this degree that I've been waiting 15 years to do. There was so many things and so many decisions. So leading up to this weekend, the story that's on the website, I figured if I talk to my mom, she'd talk some sense into me because my mom, she's from the school of you go to school, you get a degree, you get a good job, you stay there for 30 years, you retire, happy ever after, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so I figured if I went to her, I kind of felt like I knew what she was going to say. Like she was going to tell me, take my cell phone back to work, you know, because if I don't, who am I going to be borrowing money from? From her.
Right.
So mm-hmm. I figured she'd tell me, you know, going back to work and then I'd be mad at her. She won't let me live my dream. So now I got somebody to blame. Well, I get there, and she disappoints me.
Ooh.
And I'd been crying. I'd been crying all weekend, basically. So there was a group of people that I had met. I'd never met a group of people like this that worked together. I didn't know anything about working in the business world. I've had a job, and I've been on committees, and I've done community service and volunteered and been in a church, but never with a group of business owners or entrepreneurs. And then to see them work together, I was like, I want this all the time. And I was helping another group put on a networking event, and they allowed me to have some input, and some of what I did made the networking event we did really good. And it was, no one had to tell me, Catherine, you did a good job. I could see what I added was good, and that felt good, and it made a difference. And that was Thursday night. I went back to work on Friday. Saturday, this same group of people, we went out to support another business owner, peer, and I was like, I want this all the time. And then I was sad. I was sad. I had to go home, and I was crying like somebody died because 2 days I was going to have to go back to this job where I wasn't appreciated. My check was on time, but I wasn't appreciated, and I wasn't making a difference. And I'm just going here, and I felt like my day was like blah, 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 blah. So Sunday morning, I said, okay, you know what? My mom will be the voice of reason. She's going to tell me what to do. And I thought I knew what she was going to say. So I get over there, and I'm crying, my eyes all swollen. And she was like, what's wrong with you? And I said, you know, I want to live my dream. And she says, oh, you know, and at the time I was helping a friend with their magazine. She said, oh, that newspaper thing you're doing? And I was like, yeah, it's a magazine. Yeah. And she was like, well, just go do it. Go live your dream. And I held my head up. I was in her bedroom at this point, crying on the side of her bed. She has this high bed. So I'm sitting on the stool, leaning on the bed, crying. I look at her, and I'm going, that did not help me. So it's like I was crying. And then when she said, just live your dream, I stopped crying. Like, that didn't feel any better. I was just not clear. So I was like, well, who's going to go to my job tomorrow? That's what I'm thinking in my head.
<That's right.
laughs> Somebody got to pay these bills. So my mom was like, live your dream. And so I cried worse, got home, and I was like, man, tomorrow I got it. So it's like sand going through this, you know, the hourglass. I got to go to work tomorrow. I got to make a decision. So Monday morning comes, and I know I'm taking a long way around this, but I want people to really get this because I get what people go through when they're thinking about this decision in their life. What do I do? Monday morning comes, and I still have some sick days, so in my head, well, you can just call out, you know, a couple of days. You don't have to go right now. You don't have to make this decision right now, I'm saying to myself. But when the secretary answered the phone and said hello, I said, this is Miss Waddell. I won't be back.
Mm.
And she said, oh, okay, Miss Waddell, you won't be in today? I'll let the principal know. And I was like, no, I won't be back. That sounds brave today, right?
Yeah,
I'm sitting on the side of my bed on that day holding my breath like I don't have the nerve to repeat this one more time. I'm going to be like, I'll be late. I was getting ready to say, I'll be late.
Wow.
So I was like, well, I'll let the principal know myself. But anyway, that is the end of it. And I hung up the phone. I did feel peace. Well, 5 weeks later, things went crazy with me and my friends at the magazine, and I had no job, and I had no dream to live.
Ooh.
And that was really scary because I thought I had a plan. And then by the time things went crazy with the magazine, I got the letter from the school system saying not eligible for rehire, and I was like, God, what have I done? What have I done? And 6 years later, I'm still here. I still live indoors, but there's a journey, and you have to think about what is it that you're willing to give up for this, how bad do you want it? And at 5 weeks into this, I had to ask myself a question, what is it that you're even out here trying to get, you know? So it's not like I had a clear plan of radio at that point. I didn't.
Just fell into it. All right, we're going to get into that. We're going to take a commercial break. Miss Catherine, we get back, we're going to listen to the end of your story, well, the rest of your story, because, wow, this is something that, you know, what's so fascinating about you telling the story, the way you're telling it. We actually have a group of people coming on tonight on The Storm. That's right. For those of you that's inside the virtual studio, you have an opportunity to listen to The Storm interview someone at 9:30. A group of these people, like I guess you call them facilitators, they empower people to go out and fulfill their dreams. You know, pretty much what you're doing. Just go out there and whatever you're doing part-time while you're doing your full-time job, they kind of encourage you to do it. So that's what they do.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to find out a little bit more about how they do it tonight at 9:30 on The Storm with Benita Claiborne. That's right.
All right,
we're talking to Catherine Waddell. That's right. And her website is thisneedstobesaid.com. And we're going to take a quick break, and we're going to listen to one song and maybe two commercials, if that's okay with Catherine. We got to get them in, okay? And then we'll be able to finish up the show with you. All right, everybody, hold tight. You're listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide on PositivePower21.org, and you're about to listen to my girl Keisha Dreams of Sector 7, Survivor.
My chest and the tears from my eyes, but nevertheless, they said that they loved me but want me to fall. In your presence is where I would call. You hid me all in all. I love them and you tell me how.
Pain not took ridiculous, but what God did magnificent. And sure it'll make you more. Took my life and he gave a cure. Blessed so great it'll make you slur. Time and time I got it for. Winning souls what I'm aiming for. That's what I wanna be famous for.
I'm a survivor. I'm a survivor. You took away my scars, my God, you washed from me.
I'm a survivor. I'm a survivor.
You can nothing but love, my God, you washed from me.
I'm a survivor.
Hey.
I'm a survivor.
Ridiculous,
but what God did magnificent. Pressed and sure to make you more. Took my life and it gave a cure. Blessed so great and it make you sir. Time and time my God is sir. Winning souls what I'm aiming for. That's what I want to be famous for. Yeah.
on. Don't forget about Tea Time Thursdays with Jerry Voice Live Worldwide on PositivePower21.org.
A poetry book written by Philip Beery, testimonial of one's true greatness. Without the touching and compelling healing story, one wouldn't be able to tell the grace and the goodness of God's ultimate and testimonial glory. These stories and the uplifting messages behind the concept and the meaning of this book is mostly about overcoming tough challenges, obstacles, and giving God all the well-deserved glory and the highest praise. This book is available on Amazon.com in digital and hard copy, and you can find it at Infinity Publishing at buybooksontheweb.com. Testimonial of One's True Greatness by poet Philip Beery.
You are listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide Podcast.
All right, you tell them, robot. You listen to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide. It's right here on PositivePower21.org with Catherine Waddell. And her website is thisneedstobesaid.com. Now, Catherine, can people still listen to your shows? You still out there?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Actually, today's show, we talked, it was a conversation with girlfriends, one of my commentators. They got really deep into the Caitlyn Jenner topic. So we talk about just things that you, the conversations that you wonder about or things that are on your mind. We also have talked of politics this week as well. So we have a daily dose of weird news segment that comes on. It's real news. It's just weird news. Mm-hmm. And so we talked about finances this week, all from the point of what's your relationship with money, building wealth through insurance, and then, what to do when a loved one dies. So how to prepare for those things. So we cover a gamut of topics, but, yes, they can still tune in to the shows. Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, your shows come on during the day, during daytime, live?
Yes, 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
All right. People would love that. He's still at the office. California.
That's right. Give you something to do.
I love podcast. I was out on iTunes the last couple of days because I actually launched our website through their feed, but I haven't found it yet. I'm still waiting. Did they approve me yet or what? So I don't know what's going on. I couldn't find my button. He claimed he was out there. I couldn't find him. I was like, how do you find people? I found T.D. Jakes and Joyce Myers and them. So I said, well, maybe
you should be able to find TNTBS as well. We're on iTunes.
Oh, yeah, I found you. I couldn't find my buddy. He told me he was out there. I couldn't find him. I found you. Remember?
I wonder sometimes if they abbreviate it because I think you have to search for me by TNTBS. I don't know. It may be another abbreviation for a show or even by his name. Did you try by his name?
Yeah, I think I'm going to try by his name because I think they did have yours abbreviated when I found you. And and remember I told you there wasn't no shows on there.
Right. Well, we're transitioning. And some of our newer commentators are getting acclimated to that. So we'll be back up full steam. But we have over, 1,200 shows, so they got plenty to listen to while we get straight.
While
we get back on track because we got people transitioning in and out.
Good. All right, let's talk about your platform then.
Our platform is for business owners.
Go
ahead.
Okay, I just will tell everybody, they can read about your story on your website.
Yeah.
needstobesaid.com.
Yeah, there'll be plenty of opportunities to hear more about that.
Because we want to try to get a little bit more about you out here so people understand what your program is about. So go ahead, explain your platform. We ready.
Okay. the platform is for business owners. I believe if you can teach what you know, you ought to be in radio. It's another way that people can market their business. It's another way that people can window shop them because so many of our businesses are online. So you don't have a storefront window for people to walk by and say, I think I like that. You know, so it's a way for you to build content as well as build relationships with your ideal client. So over the past 6 years, I've mastered that where business owners bring their knowledge to the platform and they share it. So we have everyone from therapists to NLP, which is neuro-linguistic programmers, hypnotists. We've had attorneys, doctors. And we've had people that work with finances, credit repair, parents, because we talk about parenting topics. We've had politicians on. So we have a wide variety of people and topics because it can help expand their brand as well as it educates people, because people buy from who they know, they like, and they trust. And if you can be a part of a platform and you can teach somebody how to better understand what you offer, they're going to begin to trust you because they feel like you care, because you've taken the time, because they don't get paid to teach you on radio. They're doing this as a part of their marketing strategy, so you get to tune in for free, you know, and you get to get this wealth of information, and it's good information. I mean, you say, okay, yeah, I've heard that before, but I didn't like that person who told me. You may like one of our commentators. So we use a platform for business owners to grow, and some of the business owners have gone on to do other things, do their own radio shows, to be in syndication on other platforms, to get speaking engagements. And one lady, she not only syndicated her segment that she was doing about positive thinking on the program, but she's also learned to do voiceover work, which she hadn't even thought about doing that. So now she's the one that does all of my commercials for my show, and she buys airtime for me to do that.
Yeah, and that is awesome. And that's exactly what we're doing with our platform, trying to teach the podcasters how to look at this as a legitimate business, because one of the guys, I was crying for a moment, he just jumped into business. He was doing it years ago, but I think he was over the airways, and he really loved the power of the Internet, and he started back up, like, really, really fast, and he was broadcasting out of Brooklyn, New York. And just recently, he stopped his programming. I think he was running January. I think he just stopped like 2 weeks ago. He went to Puerto Rico, and I guess he must have had epiphany or something. And he came back, and he told me his show is going to be on demand for subscriptions. You have to buy a subscription. And I was like, wow, you know, it's like that. He said, yeah, his audience has really grown. And he think he was at that point where, you know, he had to slow down a little bit, because he was doing a 6 a.m. show. I think he was broadcasting 2-3 hours per day. Maybe it was 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And starting very early in the morning, I think 6 to 8, and then he would run recordings and things like that. So he was burnt out, you know. It's hard doing it every day, you know, that early. You know, Internet is so fast. You have to do a lot of research, and you want good guests. How important is that, having good guests on your show?
Very important. And a good guest is an interesting guest, and it carries your conversation, and people want to tune into that, because if you have somebody who is not fun, not interesting, stumbles over themselves, seems like they're disconnected, it just messes up the energy and the vibe. It's like,
So you got to carry the show. So the host got to carry the show. So it helps
by them themselves. So you might as well be there by yourself, mute the person, and just go for it. Yeah.
I have a question for you, too. When it comes to you, because I'm in your situation, when it comes to you selecting who you wish to podcast, now, how you work in your platform? Are you selling airtime, or you're like, if it's somebody that's unique and you have to have them, are you offering them free airtime? Are you billing on that? That part of your business?
In the beginning I was, because that worked, and if you have something there already, other people will come. But I'm more selective in the point of, we're sitting down, it's a business. So I want you to look at this as part of your marketing pie. Like, you may do some social media advertising, you may run some commercials on mainstream radio for your show, but think of Oprah and Dr. Phil and Iyanla Vanzant. You've established a platform, and these people are coming, and they're benefiting from what you've worked so hard for. So, like myself, I have over 65,000 Twitter followers. I have a lot less. I have like 4,000 Facebook fan page and almost 3,000 on my personal page, and I have 422 people following me. Like, I don't know what following on Facebook is, but you have all of this attention. I have about 400 people on YouTube, and even one of my students, she has like 2,000, like she has more people than me. But the thing is, it's a business. All of these are marketing outlets. So I've worked really hard to have these people follow me, connect with me, trust me, depend on me to bring them a little bit of humor, a little thought-provoking conversation. So for me to just let someone get on that at this point doesn't make sense. So I do lease airtime for them to use that, because now they understand this is a business expense.
Mm-hmm.
This is part of your budget. and you need to invest in yourself. And here's what I learned early on. I did it to fill spaces at first, but as time went on, I learned not to do that because after a while they didn't care, they didn't show up, people didn't call. And I mean, 5 minutes before we need to go on air, they're telling me I'm not there. So it's like a lot of stuff you have to do on your feet. But if a person has to financially invest in it, they have a different perspective.
Yeah.
They do. And then when you sit down and have that talk with them, not only are they paying, but you sit down and have a talk with them and said, this is a business. This is part of your marketing strategy. And people, you know, do business with who they know, they like, and they trust. And if you don't show up, the audience can't trust you.
Right.
You know, so you have a talk, and you train them. So you give them, you know, the support they need because I tell them, I do radio. Your business is, you know, whatever it is, whether it's credit repair or you're a doctor or you're an attorney. That's your business. Like, I don't want it to become a burden to them, but I want them to also take it seriously.
Right.
So you have to have that conversation with them as well as put some fee in place, you know.
That's right. That's right. So, good idea. And
I don't know that I've ever needed to have someone after learning that lesson. Let me put it that way, because I have done that before and said, I need to have this person. They'd be really great, and I have them on. But I learned there never be anybody I have to have that bad on my show.
Wow. Yeah.
Yep. Lessons learned. Lessons learned.
Lesson learned.
Mm-hmm.
All right. We're talking to Catherine Waddell, and she's running thisneedstobesaid.com. Check out her website. She is a multimedia, well, strong media out there. And you're broadcasting exclusively on Blog Talk Radio. Any other networks they can find you?
iTunes only because it directly feeds from Blog Talk.
Yeah, awesome. All right. So that's where she's at. That's right. And like I said, I did try to pull you down iTunes because I was trying out iTunes and see how good it sounded on my – so I always like to test things first before I invest time in it. And it took me some time just to get where I am right now with iTunes because I just love the platform I'm on right now because, one, you know, like so many people, you know, I know – you want to give everybody an impression of having a live show, but I'm like, sometimes the internet just can't be trusted. So for me, I want people to be comfortable, and I don't want to be panicking that I'm like, wait a minute, we've been talking all this time. This thing is dead. So I went through that. So Skype gave me a hard lesson, a real hard lesson. After dealing with Skype, I think that was the most extreme madness you can get as a podcaster. So it's like after that, I said, nothing could be as bad as that. So here I am right now, taking advantage of, you know, the virtual studio where people can come in and have a good time. Cause sometimes we do the party line with this thing and everybody has fun. And then if I say, okay, it's appropriate, I can broadcast it, you know, share it, you know. But right now we are June 5th, 2015, we went exclusively Christian Network. So the conversations do get kind of deep with a lot of the podcasters, but I know still it's kind of safe in a way.
Right?
Yeah, I listen to them all too. So, all right, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, you know, we want you to give us your final thoughts on tonight's broadcast. And again, just, you know, just let everybody know where they can find you at and on social media. Okay, sound good?
Absolutely. Thank you.
All right. Quick break, y'all. It's going to be a music break. I love this lady right here. Let's check it out. Marilyn Dunn. She always pump me up.
You can't get through. listening to PositivePower21.org with Jerry Royce.
All right. Thank you, kids. All three of my kids. Just love them to death. Thank you for bringing me in. We're finishing up the show with Catherine. That's right, Catherine. She has this beautiful website out there called ThisNeedsToBeSaid.com for all kinds of empowerment information. You looking to promote your business, this is the place to be. So check her out. She got testimonies out there, everything. All right, Catherine Waddell, you ready to take us home? Tell people they can find you out there on social media.
Absolutely. Do a Google search. That'll be the easiest way to find everything other than going to thisnewsbesaid.com, and it'll show you Twitter, Instagram, and all that stuff so that you can find me in one place. But thisnewsbesaid.com is easy peasy, and it'll lead you to anything, our blog, anything that you want to connect to in one spot. And I want to leave your audience just with one thought as they're thinking about living their dream, whether it's finding that job and climbing the corporate ladder or starting their own business or being a mom, whatever their dream is, just respect the process. It's going to take a while. You know, it wasn't built overnight. Nothing was built overnight. Success doesn't come overnight. And for all of those times it felt like we've seen overnight success, that takes about 5 to 10 years just to begin to see something like that. Yeah. So it takes a lot of building of your foundation. So don't rush, you know, don't rush the process. Just respect it and go with That's it right. and be happy and know it's going to happen for you. How? We don't know, but just go with the process.
That's right. Amen. Just do the best you can and try to be great and things will happen. You know, you want to give a good product and a good service, and so people know to get their money's worth, or they say, oh wow, you offering all of that for this? Wow, that's great. You know, you always want them to walk away with a smile and tell somebody else about what you're doing. That's the quickest way of becoming successful. Word of mouth.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So you have quite a business, quite a hit on your hands, and congratulations to you. Love meeting other people that's in the same business and doing it successfully, because, you know, you want to know if it works. Like, why am I doing it right? You know, am I the only one out there? Because everybody else you meet is like falling by the wayside. He's confused and got so much stuff going on. And like, ooh, you know, what did I just walk into? You know, but I love this business. Everything about it, the people, the challenge. I mean, you always train yourself for the challenge. You kind of was prepared anyway. God prepare you for this kind of stuff. That's how you built. You was built for this, you know. You know it. Mm-hmm. You know it from the jump. Mm-hmm. And that is so great. And we hope to have you back, maybe co-host a show, maybe get some other podcasters. Yeah, we need to get some podcasters together. I know some great ones that's under ownership, leading their own parade. So we have to get in here and talk about the fun stuff of the business.
Right. Oh, and there is, yeah. I didn't mean to sound so serious. There's lots of fun stuff.
Yeah.
Lots of fun stuff in the business. Oh, my goodness. The perks.
Right.
We could definitely – I would love to come back. I would be honored to be your guest or co-host on your show.
Yeah, we get along so great anyway, so we have to hook up again. We have to.
Absolutely.
All right, and share some leads too, you know, some stuff that's going on in the area. One of the things we're hoping to be doing in the Baltimore area, in Washington, in between the saving stations, you know, I'm putting together some saving radio stations, and we're going to be hoping to bring the people together so we can start connecting, so we can start having podcasts, little podcast conferences. There's a few going on. I'm going to start checking on some of the guys and see how they feel about some of the first-timers, and maybe that's the ways that a lot of us can meet is at some of the, you know, the podcast events that's going on. So that might be something we can do. Maybe you already know of some that we could try out.
I actually, geared specifically for podcasts, I do not know, but I will definitely keep my ears and eyes open for that, because I think it's much needed, for sure. And I know the different platforms may do different things, but I think it's absolutely needed because it's a viable entity. I went to a blogger conference a couple of weekends ago, and they are considered influencers, which means that the big names like Toyota, Wells Fargo, Coca-Cola are willing to give them money to advertise on their site. So these are people who write blogs about their opinion about something, fashion, entertainment, parenting, whatever it is.
Right.
So they have been marked, labeled as an influencer. And I'm not putting that down. I just think online broadcasters, radio shows, podcasters
should have a place in that conversation as well. So I don't know of anything at this point, but I will keep my eyes and ears open because I think it would be empowering to meet, like you said, to help people. Because some people do it as a hobby because maybe they don't know that it could be a business. So that would be great. I do want to share with your audience, there's a conference for women. I don't mean to leave the men out. You can come, but it's geared towards women in business. Me and four other ladies are in a mastermind group, and we have created something that will be quite valuable. We have videos and audio and lots of online activities for women who are wanting to grow their business, learning how to elevate themselves in 90 days. So we have some free content. So if you hang out with me, meet me over at thisneedstobesaid.com. I will lead you over to where this conference is happening. And actually, we began the process this past Monday. And we want as many women as possible to be a part of it. Do you have to physically go anywhere? No. You can do this stuff online. And usually, it's at most of what we're doing is going to be at your own pace. So you don't have to be anywhere. You don't have to show up at a certain time online or call in at a certain time. This stuff is going to be, you sign up, and it's going to be sent to your email, and you can listen to the videos, watch them, and, you know, follow us. I think we have one activity that's going to be live, and that's our Periscope Day on October 8th. So we got a lot going on, and we'd love for you all to participate.
Keep us in the loop, and I'll tell my crew. All right, Kev, we got to get out of here. We got another show. We're running behind, but we appreciate you. And we will definitely make that all happen. All right, y'all. I tell
y'all
all the time, you want to hear the good stuff, you got to listen to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide on PositivePower21.org. Check us out 24/7 on Spreaker Radio /PositivePower21. Again, I'm Jerry Royce Live. I'm worldwide.
Thank you for tuning in to Jerry Royce Live on PositivePower21.org and Spreaker.com /PositivePower21. This is a Royce Enterprises production. And don't forget about replay on Facebook.com/Jerry Royce Live.